Hi everyone, it's Simon Keeling here and it's Friday the 19th of June. Thanks again for watching. This is your look ahead video here at weatherweb.net. And bringing you up to date with the latest El Nino predictions. The IRI have issued their latest El Nino plume. So what we're looking at here are the outputs from the various different long-range computer models and the predictions that they're making of El Nino. And we can take a mean through of the statistical model average, which is through here. Also the dynamical model average, which is through here. And then we can look at the CPC con through there. What they're coming in with is a general peak in El Nino through October, November, December, and the mean is coming in about plus 1.5. Now, we're turning down our forecast, going for about a plus 1.8. We did go plus 1.8 to 2. I'm probably pulling it back a little bit now, down to 1.8. I think slightly above the mean of these forecasts. But what's interesting is that the CFS and the JMA have both now toned things down a little bit on their predictions made in mid-May, which indeed was this one. And you see here that they were going up to sort of 2.8, whereas now they've pulled them down to around a 2.5. So certainly we've seen this kind of easing off of the top end of the El Nino predictions from those models. So they're pulling it back a little bit. And then we're seeing this peak, as I said, October, November, December. The statisticals seeing it as a peak a little bit later, and then pulling it off quite dramatically as we head through the winter months. And in fact, getting into just a 0.8 again. So return to where we were by the time we're getting through to February, March and April of next year. So into spring of 2016. It's something that we've got to bear in mind whenever we're looking at the longer ranges, particularly the CFS and the JMA, who both happen to be the main long-range producer centres, and when we're looking at these forecasts, because they are going to be taking the El Nino into account, and quite significantly as well, because it has such a large impact on the weather across the planet. Of course, they're going to be taking other factors in as well, which will water down that El Nino effect, excuse the pun. But it's something that we've just got to be aware of when we're looking at the CFS and the JMA. Talking of the CFS, this is the latest output from the CFS for week one. Put in a trough now across the eastern parts of Europe during the course of this week, bringing in settled conditions there. Generally a ridge across the UK from the high that you see here out towards the west, but that's not lasting, because by the time we're into week two, from the 26th of June to the 2nd of July, look, we're seeing these lower than normal heights going across the west of the UK, above normal just to the south. So I think the idea that we've had many southern parts of England, possibly southern Wales, still on the dry side. It's not going to be completely dry, but certainly not large totals. Wetter of the weather, Northern Ireland and Scotland. That seems to be what CFS is trying to pick up on here. As I've been stressing, it's not a washout. It's more mixed conditions overall. Although it's now hinting at something more unsettled, more widely across the country during the period the 3rd to the 9th of July. Look, central low heights in here, jet stream across the country, not particularly very strong, but across the country. So it could be we do go into a more unsettled period from the 3rd to the 9th of July. And then week 4, you see that unsettled period predicted not to be lasting that long. The low heights getting squeezed off to the north, building pressure off towards the west again. More of a northwesterly flow coming in here across the UK. So cooler conditions, more settled conditions getting in according to the CFS middle of the month. I think that's probably incorrect. I think what will happen is that the mixed weather continues up till around the 16th of July. And then we see an improvement after that. How long it's going to last for though, I'm not entirely convinced. I don't think it'll be particularly long-lasting improvements, but I think we're going to have to put up with the first half of July probably being mixed. And as for August, well, August. I'll show you more about that in the next few days. Anyway, I'll leave you with that for now, but whatever you're doing, thanks again for watching. Don't forget to get a forecast for the next couple of days. Check out Gary's Fast Forecast. But have a great weekend. Thanks for watching. Keep the sun shining, and bye for now.